Howdy folks, welcome back to Subnautica Below Zero. I realized this morning that I've been kind of neglecting this game. I've actually been playing on my own for about 3 hours doing some base building and unloading the SeaTruck from the last trip and getting everything sorted into proper lockers and adding to the base and whatnot. So I'll show you that first, and then we'll hop in the sea truck and go hunt down those couple of alien artifacts that are still outstanding. All right, let's get rid of this. Now, this is just an empty room at this point, but this will give you an idea of what I intend to do with it. I've got a whole ton of crap that can be grown indoors in a locker in another room. So I have to look at what I have, decide where to put it, what would look best aesthetically to have things grouped together. Whatnot. And because I've been playing for a couple hours already, I don't want to spend any more time on that right now. It says emergency exit there. What does it say over here? Oh, it says exit to nuclear reactor. So let's walk over there. Look at the scenery. Look at the icebergs. There's your exit. And keeping it way out here keeps down the humming sound. Recyclotron, fabricator for making more reactor rods or getting rid of the old ones. These are all good. You can see my inventory. This is the last of the stuff that I took out of the sea truck. This is the last trip. I haven't put it away yet, so we'll have to go do that. Reinforcement panels all the way around. And a bulkhead. And being way out here keeps the noise level down. In fact, you can't hear it from this far away at all. Show you around the outside a little bit. Moon pool. Glass tubes on everything. That's the large room we were in. This is the control room. I think it says Nautilus base. Yeah, Nautilus base. I've been doing a little planting. I've got four of the big creep vine that have the seed clusters. They'll glow real nice at night. There were some ribbon plants, some cotton anemone, and some gel sacks, and then some violet bow and some red wort. So that's the gardens, outdoor garden so far. We looked at, I pointed out the moon pool already. We got the other moon pool with its bulkhead down here. Of course, there's an entrance there. This one is completely shielded. Let's go check out the aquarium.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
I've got, this is a double stack. I've got some red wart, violet bow, cotton anemone. That's a mesmerizer. Well, lily paddler is what they call it. You see what that is? That's squid shark. Squid shark. There's two of them. And inventory's full in this double stacked tank. We can go up. We're at the top of the double stack. Lots of stuff in here I could scan, yes. I hatched a penguin from an egg. And of course, all the exotic varieties, the lily paddler, the brute shark, the squid sharks, and that thing, the arrow ray, were all hatched from eggs. Can't forget the rock punchers. Thought I only had one. No, I think I did have two. They don't procreate like they used to. Hey, watch it there, Pinacarid. All right. You can go upstairs. There's really nothing to see. Oh, there is something to see. My bedroom. I haven't found anything pretty that I would like to put in there. I've got like marble melon plants or Chinese potato, but so what, you know? I want some flowers. In the last Subnautica, there was some speckled rattler and this other kind of pinkish flower. They were real nice, and I would fill up the pots with them. So maybe I'll have to try and spawn some of them. Unless they've been taken out of the game, you know, then you can't spawn them. Shower, you can interact. Turn it on and off. You can turn the aromatherapy on. Keep the smell down in the bathroom. Interact. Trash can. Some shelving for stuffing with clothes or towels, washcloths, extra supplies, whatever. You can sit here to get dressed. Table for just a shit collector, whatever you want, whatever you need to set down. If you gotta empty out your pockets before you strip, whatever. This shelf, besides holding the aromatherapy, you could use an end for all your shower needs and an end for all your toiletry. So, and you got a trash can. Wonderful. Got two ways in and out. You can come straight in from the master bedroom, or the bedroom, or come in this way. If you come in through the hatch there, and you really, really need to go, you got the toilet right there. You can hit it fast. You know, those times when you got about 10 seconds to run to the toilet? You know what I mean. Where does this go? See, I started to put some signs with this first room. Okay, this is the first room. Started to put some signs. You know, I don't want to waste time on it right now, but like here I could put exit to base. Something like that. What we just walked through, the scanner room, control room. So we could do, I guess I am gonna spend time on it now. We could do like, by the way, it's easier to edit the sign if you put the scanner away or the habitat builder. There you go. Control room that way. Hard to see exactly where it's going, but at any rate, put that away, click edit, and then I don't think we need an arrow on this, but I like having them yellow because they're high visibility. Click on it to type and say exit to base. Wonderful. See how easy it is to put signs up? Here we are back with the aquariums. This is the upper room. See, eventually I'll put signs everywhere. This is the lower room with nothing but the aquarium. A couple battery chargers, some extra lockers. This, I believe, ends up at a moon pool. Yeah. Okay. We looked at that from outside. Coffee machine. That's the other moon pool. Lockers, lockers, lockers everywhere. Inactive. There's nothing in it? Well, I can't do that till I get rid of the other shit. What have I got on me? Quartz, copper, titanium. Oh boy. All right. Well, I got a locker back here that says mix. Because it's kind of the oddball stuff that I don't have lockers for yet. And it's acting as an overflow right now. Got a crap ton of water. If I decide to take it off of freedom. Right now I've got it on freedom mode instead of survival. Titanium. So I don't need to eat and drink. I didn't want to mess around with that bullpucky when I was just walking around doing shit or floating around outside deconstructing all the metal tubing and putting all the glass tubing in its place. You know, stuff like that. I just didn't want to have to screw around with it. I'll put this extra bladderfish in there. I can grab... See, this is the stuff I can plant. Fevered pepper, shrub nuts. I think I'd have to plant that outside as well as these. But you've seen that I already have the planters full. Frost vase seed. I think those would look be pretty. I'd like to plant these, but I think you can only eat them to make salads. I'm not sure on that. Here's all the stuff. You know, poster, shaving kit, frame picture, poster, 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 poster. Poster, poster. I gotta figure out where I want all that shit. You know, the shaving kit could go in the bathroom. On the shelf with the aromatherapy, maybe? Too bad you can't simulate a mirror. Use the picture frame to simulate a mirror. Maybe take a, put a picture of Robin in the mirror, in the picture frame. So you could imagine that she's standing in front of the sink and the mirror is showing her reflection. Hey, that's an idea. But anyways, we're going to grab some creepvine sample out of here. Only need 4. In the original Subnautica, creepvine would last forever. Now, in below zero, it eats it up in a matter of a couple hours. It seems to do better with fish. I got another base. I have 2 other bases. Since we did a video last. And one of those bioreactors, I stuffed it full with penglings. And because I trapped them in my aquarium, and I tried to let them go, and they come right back. They race back to the aquarium and get caught again. So I couldn't get rid of the suckers, but I got to get them out of my aquarium because they fill it up. So I stuffed the bioreactor with 4, 8, 12, 16 of those dang penglings. And then I let the rest of them go away, long ways away from the sea truck. So, I didn't want that. I just wanted to point. Dang it. There. I want to be able to move my mouse. So that's growing in power now. we'll end up with a total of 3,300 when you count in the nuclear reactor. So whether this is running or not really doesn't make any difference, except it gives me a little more power. Let's see. Go over here and turn left. No, that's the aquarium we looked at. We gotta go out to that one. Is this? I thought this was a moon pool. Yeah, it is. I've got, you can see one of my other bases there, deep hole base. There's your reinforcement, the console is centered in the back, the door is centered in the other end. And so there's that leaves room for four reinforcement panels, and the sea truck, when you dock the sea truck, it'll dump you out to one side. When you dock the prawn suit, it dumps you out to the other side. So I put it dead center of the back wall, so either way it dumps you out, you just walk to the back. It's, what do they call that, unisex? Whatever. All right, the only thing left is the other aquarium. I think I gotta go upstairs. It's easier to find shit if you just swim to it from the outside. Now it's getting dark, you know, you can see my, the lighted up Nautilus shows up better. The plants will show up better. That's lockers and, you know, water machine and cyclotron and just other stuff. I could do another creepvine plant outside or just use it to make oil. Here's where I would chant. Plant Chinese potato, more shrub nuts, reinforced or synthetic fibers. It's pretty much the same thing that's in this one. I should just try and combine it, or maybe separate out this stuff and then combine that stuff. Let's see. Yeah, I like that idea. I gotta get this stuff. No, that's my stuff. Now this is the locker. Bug flying around. I'm not sure what if you can plant those. I think you can. I would like to plant the Preston's leaf so I can have more of it to make salads anytime I want. They're very nutritious. They do food and they have food and water value. Between that and marble melon and Chinese potato, shrub nuts, fever peppers. God, you wouldn't even need to hunt fish. But I'm not sure if you can plant them. I tried once and it didn't work. I don't know. Anyways, we gotta move along. This is what's in the locker. This is what's in my inventory. So I want to move this over to the locker. Almost, you know, forgot what I was doing. Now move all of this. I can take the fish too. But I don't want the plant stuff. Okay, now this locker is all plant stuff. Whether it's indoor or outdoor. The blue is outdoor, the green is indoor. Maybe I was trying to plant this indoor. That's why it didn't work. I don't even remember anymore. Take that and take that. Now that locker is organized. And now all this goes over here until I figure out what to do with it. Where to put up all the posters, what they even look like. Those are both SeaTruck. They're both the same thing. This is something about focus. Keep calm and truck on. I should have one of those by the exit. Mercury 2, Mercury 2. Maybe above the bed? Have a big Mercury 2 poster? Wonder how big they are. Anyways, I'm rambling. Let's get out of here. I emptied my storage, my personal storage. I got an extra battery. All these batteries are full. I'm not sure how many. Well, I got two marker buoys. I got a mineral detector, tether tool, an air bladder I never use, couple of flares to chase off whatever. I don't know why I'm even carrying the propulsion cannon, except that it ends up being able to fill all 12 spots. Got it all, man. Got it all. Let's get out of here. Let's go investigate a couple of artifact signals. SeaTruck, I reduced the length of it by a couple of storage units. It had four storage units on it, and the length was so excessive. And when I was mining the mine with the prawn suit, I needed four storage units. I needed more than that. I had to make a couple of trips, even with four storage units. So I cut the storage units down to two. There's me prawn. I put ion batteries and everything. This is the, what the hell do they call this? It's the room you come back to when you use the tether tool. If you're out somewhere and you use the tether tool, you come back here to that pad. Sleeper berth with a picture of the SeaTruck. This is when I had 4 storage units on it. You can play music, except I'd probably get a copyright strike if I did, because I have my own music library on here. That's Bob Dylan, and then it goes into, oh God, what is it? All of a sudden my memory, you know. Bush, yes. Oh, stop moving closer. Bush. Glycerin, more Bush, more Bush. Cat Stevens, Creed. A lot of Creed. Destiny's Child, Falco, Garbage.
Girl, don't come.
Holy shit.
It's something said and done. Don't hang around.
Sorry about that. Alright. Keep it under 10 seconds or something. Maybe they won't care. Fat chance. I filled up this storage with just some crap I had in the lockers in case I needed to make something. I have no idea if, you know, there's like no lead, there's no lithium, there's no silver. You know, there's a lot of stuff not in here that you might need, but, you know, maybe I can pick up some shit along the way. Otherwise, these lockers are empty. Not all of them. Up here, I've got some extra batteries, a couple kyanite, some oil, ribbon plant, magnetite, one lithium, woohoo! Piece of titanium didn't fit down there. Some rubber, only 2 salt. Maybe I should grab some salt from the locker at the base. Got lots of salt for doing fish at the base. Oh, got more salt here. Okay, a couple more lithium, 4 more batteries, 6 water, 2 coffee that are empty. Might have to construct, if I need coffee, I'll just make a coffee maker. I could throw down a 4-way, put a couple solar panels on it, go inside and make a coffee maker. Cold suit, more miscellaneous supplies, hydraulic fluid for the bridge in the glacial basin, antidote for the giant leviathan, the frozen leviathan, pangling, should I need that. Look here, I got some nickel, gold, complete cold suit. I got the shit set up to go do some exploring, just I need the time, because, you know, it's 4:45 in the afternoon, and we've been on for half an hour already. I still gotta think about squeezing in a Subnautica or a SnowRunner video. So just how much time am I supposed to spend on this? No, you know what I think I'll do? I think I'll cut it right here. This episode will be 35 minutes. A base progress exploration. And the next one will be launching out in the sea truck to go do stuff. Ooh, the batteries are low on this. Between this recording and starting the next one, I will take care of that. No, actually, that's the health. The batteries are 97%. It's just the health. All right, I'll fix that. All right, see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.